Message of March 19, 1998. I see Jesus, at his side is Saint Joseph. He is carrying a white lily. Jesus says, I wanted my earthly father to come with me in this blessed house to offer you, my beloved daughter, my best wishes with the same love in which I addressed them to my father Joseph. Today my heart is full of joy because the church remembers his name, of he who together with Mary took care of that child born for the love of God, who later would have had to redeem the sins of the world. Now I want to talk to you about the love of Joseph. I want to make everyone feel the love of this humble son of God. The memories of my childhood are linked to the love of Mary's spouse, my mother, who remained a divine example of the Father's love for the children of God. He always had loving care for me and for my mother. It was he who saved the little Jesus by going to Egypt. It was he who bore in his heart all the sufferings of the father for his own child. It was he who anxiously sought me out during my dispute with the priests of the temple. Joseph was my model of life until the day when the Father called him to himself to share in the glory of paradise and wanted him on his right for the love he had for me during his life made only of work and sacrifice. And the invitation I address to my children today from this blessed land is that they are all like my father Joseph. Today I see so many families destroyed by selfishness, vanity, and the search for worldly pleasures. I ask myself why my children are no longer inspired by the love of that holy family and its ability to be united to give back hope, the certainty of redemption for all the sins that I took upon myself and carried on the cross. I left them now there to stop them causing so much damage to the whole of humanity. But the little faith in my love, the disaffection for my sacrifice, the ignorance for God's love, then the search for useless religions that are certainly not fruits of my Father's love have again reduced man to slavery and have made him a servant of sin. I love you, my children. I want to find an infinite multitude awaiting my return. What would be the point of all the sacrifices I've put my dearest children through otherwise? What would be the use of the love that the Father dispenses every hour on this island, fruit of his love? What good would my city already prepared, more beautiful than any of your imaginations? What use would it be without the children who must inhabit it soon the day when a mighty voice will command to open the doors and the human river will enter into the heart of the Father, will enter into my cradle that you, my daughter, together with your mother guarded and made grow with so much love. My daughter, invite my children to intensify meditation and prayer even more, not so much in order to hasten the times now near but so that so many children who still live in darkness can rediscover the light. My daughter, I want every day to be for my children a day of joy because it is made of communion with my Father and love for my mother. This, today, I leave to your heart. This is what my father Joseph would also like to say to you, but his humility, the love he has for me, they do not allow him to speak because everything he felt in his heart has been expressed, but he leaves you his love, he leaves you the purity of this flower wide and fresh as the early morning dew. I, Jesus, bless you and hold you close to my heart, and I also leave to you, my daughter, the love of my mother who assists you and is close to you, to give you love and comfort for all the bitterness that comes from those you would like more worthy of my love. Jesus. Giuseppina Norcia.